group of people believing, discussing and propagating about paranormal things, they are not considered to be normal people by the normal society. There must be a scale for fixing normalcy. Then we have to go beyond the scale of comprehensible and fix what is paranormal. What is normal? Before understanding paranormal and normal, you must understand that there is something infra-normal or below normal. I used to always say to people, most of the things are appearing to be paranormal because, abnormal because, you are below normal. If we are below normal, even normal things will appear to be paranormal. And those superstitious things are overwhelmed by deep insight, either in scriptures or in scientific pursuits. Whereby even the normalcy of a macroscopic happening, that may be normal to all, but a person who is below normal, for him it will be abnormal. So this is a comparative study of normalcy and abnormalcy. Whereas the phenomenal study of paranormalism is entirely different. So you have fixed that paranormal phenomena. That which is phenomenally paranormal. Normalcy means that which is possible by a person's physical, mental, intellectual, collective, federal, committed and instrumental efforts. That which is subjected to. It includes also scientific temper, scientific innovation and instrumental support. That which is possible for a person to comprehend. It does not denote a person who cannot comprehend at all. If there is a weightlifter in age, where there is a person who cannot lift even a feather, that does not mean that the person is paranormal and the person is normal. This is accessible for a person on the basis of a person's robust nature of the body by bodybuilding exercises, diet or nutrition value. There are proper other exercises which are comprehensible as well as accessible for people of the same caliber. So person having physical deficiency in the home, that is what we call homogeneous standard. In the whole homogeneous standard of the same species, he cannot claim that that is paranormal and this is normal. So normalcy, it is the maximum potential output, MPO you have to say, maximum potential output. Persons who have claimed their intellectual precision by innovative approaches like scientists, they are also normal human beings. As we are not scientists, we cannot claim them as paranormal. Persons with sharp precision in mental center, in comprehensibility, in propagation, promulgation, skills of oration, etc. There are a lot of such people. Generally, we used to claim a lot of people, each and everybody. There is certainly something known as paranormal and God-gifted. As we are totally twisted and not gifted, each and everything that we cannot access, that we least bother about access or attainment, that appears to be God-gifted paranormal. Even if somebody, normally, a child's power, ability to learn and to reproduce is more worthy. A first standard student, a proper studious student with proper nutrition, care, and concern and training, easily they can totally recite the 700 shlokas of Bhagavad Gita. 6 years is more than sufficient. It is just for all people. But somebody is a tenth of them, immediately it is considered a prodigy. It is said to be God. No, not God. He has given his gifts in all forms. But a special feature of paranormalism is very rare to be distinguished from normal things. Really, absolute paranormalism is entirely different. I'm going to classify them later. What we want to say here is, maximum potential output is there. In the same world, lot of the feeble creatures who are in a tremor, tumor and terror, suffering in the world, in the same platform, skillful people, impudent people, audacious people, bold and brave people, they are there. In the same world where there are filtered and sponsored idiots, great intellectuals and contribute to scientists are there. The same world where beauty people, nutritionally insufficient people, those who are feather lifters or breeze lifted people, in the same platform, that of other robust people there may be. We want to take them as a scale for normalcy, not these people. Maximum potential output. So, normalcy is defined as the utmost capability within the possibility of potential output of a person's physical, mental, and intellectual status. taking this as normalcy, we have to explain what is abnormal or paranormal. Whenever we go to the paranormalcy, we have several kingdoms. Paranormalcy within universal experiences and exposures. Paranormalcy in individual experiences and exposures. Paranormalcy that is within the collective society reflected between various people. And paranormalcy in its utmost enthronement of hierarchy, starting from God. Even God, as he is not comprehensible by a person's intellectual, physical and mental status, the hierarchy of paranormalism starts with God. So God, number one. Number two, we are all just bulk of biological matter. And as a matter of consciousness, we have a bundle of instincts. Apart from which, understanding that there is a soul, that is also a paranormal phenomenon. If you consider that there is something soul, which is different from DNA, genes, chromosomes, cells and tissues, then certainly that must have some distinguishable feature. What is that? That is eternity. If it is eternal, why do we die? Because of transmigration. Why you are not going to be transmigrated? Because of karma. What is karma? To start and when does it end? It is perpetual. So this has created a trio known as God, soul and karma, the bondage. So this is the starting point of religious and philosophical paranormalism. So this starts. Then after the paranormal things are there. Even there are some families, I know that if their children just get a pass in their examination, that is a paranormal phenomenon to students. If those people, they are quiet in the house, obedient, suddenly it appears to be paranormal. It is not individualistic, it is not comparative, it is not just personally motivated or disciplinized, but it is phenomenal. The second thing is, I have already told about God, karma and soul. It starts with, everything starts with power. What is paranormalism or what is God, what is soul and what is karma? Everything is a power. What is power? Power is a force which directs something as a principle, either with the will of the person, consent of the person, or even if it is not there, it is far beyond a person's acceptance and denial, subjection and refusal. So power is any driving energy unit that takes, acts, activates and conducts a mechanism in its course of activity. So God is also a power, karma is also a power, soul is also a power. The power of your soul is to do acts and to be binded by that. The power of karma is the repulsive and responsive action cycle of a person's deeds, which is having the ability to drive the mechanism of soul as per the previously committed imprints. God is a person who puppets everything. This is what the philosophy or religion claims. So it is power. Paranormalism is study about power. Even normalism, it has power. But absolute power, abundant power, inexhaustible power, ineffable power, transcendental power is studied in paranormalism. Limited power, executive power, collective power, federal power, supportive power is ready in normalism. So paranormalism, it deals with a different type of study which starts with power. Now let us start with the understanding of three major schools of thought of power. One is power of thought, second is power of belief or faith, and the third is power of will. These three things rule in religion or in spirituality or in the society. Power of thought, which is known as conation in English and sankalpa in Sanskrit, that is the power of God. When he thinks, it happens. If a person thinks that something must be done, according to the processing technology, the thought is exhibited either to a second person who is delegated to carry on the act by a process, or the person himself matures with the thought to be translated into action by his own executive skill. If I want to have some water, the thought bring water, either I must reveal it as a oral command, request or beseechment by which somebody brings water, or I must utilize the tools of grasping, the tools of lifting and the tools of reception like mouth, then I must take this water and drink. So the processive unit or the processive mechanism of a thought converted into a fruitful action is normalcy, direct connection between thought and the effect without the intrusion necessity of any process in between is known. Siddhi, accomplishment or supernatural power. Supernatural power, difference between supernatural power and natural power is supernatural power has only two uses.